You think about like the Ashland Gazette, which was a weekly, still is a weekly paper, but it was, it had offices right on Main Street on Silver. And I remember as a little kid how exciting it was to get the paper, and there was the social page that told who had a party or who had somebody over for cards.
West Ashland, East Ashland, yeah.
Yeah, and grandma always, you know, it was like if she had her parties and she played bridge, and if they were at the bridge parties, they always had on there who served and who hosted and who attended, and you wanted to see your name in the paper.
Yeah.
Right?
You know, the only thing that was bad about those bridge stories, they never said who won.
They never did.
Come on.
No, and those ladies were tight-lipped. I remember going to being at some of Grandma's bridge parties, and these were the women of the town. These were the high standing, you know. Then there was quite the little group of them that had been part of the fabric of Ashland, like in the 40s, 50s, 60s, 70s. I mean, they were part of it. And I think of some of the names, you know, that would pop through my head that would come over, and they'd have their card tables and their little thing of peanuts because they played for pennies. Uh-huh. I think the pennies meant something else, but. but those ladies, and that was part of the community, but that was their way of getting together. And they would also talk about the things in the town while they were playing cards, right? And that's how things kind of got done.
We call that gossip.
Somewhat gossip. They would call it a meeting. they would...